gotta. What are you doing? Why are you groaning and petting yourself?
I don't like it. Still itching?
Dude, he's petting his inner thigh and groaning. I don't like it.
Just need a woman.
What?
I'm just craving women.
What do you mean you have a. You're craving?
I'm craving them.
I don't like. Raph, we're about to share a hotel room together. I don't like that you're craving. Buddy, I'm scared.
They're making that movie about me. Craven.
That's about you?
Yeah. Movie's all about me, dude.
How so?
Well, he's a hunter. And
yeah.
I'm a hunter.
You're. What kind of hunter?
Do you guys think you would be gatherers?
What
or
kind
hunters?
Of hunter? No, don't. No. What kind of hunter?
Monster hunter.
Hell yeah, man.
Hell yeah.
Hell yeah.
Do you guys think you would be hunters or gatherers?
Hunter.
Like if we were all cavemen, well, I mean, we are, but like if we were
hunter
back then, you'd be a hunter?
I'd be a hunter.
Let's be honest.
No, really?
Wait, do you think you would be a hunter or a gatherer? Well, that's rude. I didn't say it like that. You were like disgusted
with
the idea.
Dude, what the f-?
She has the green
the
eyes.
The silent nod was crazy. What the f-?
She
man?
Was like this too. She was like.
Yeah. She was repulsed.
Yeah, she was sick of it. Why?
I can't even make that face.
Oh, because of all the Botox.
I don't have Botox.
No,
Botox
you famously filler. Have Botox.
I wish
famous.
I did.
It's famous.
I don't yet.
It's famous.
It's coming soon though.
What?
Do you
really? Wait, whoa.
Why?
Really? What? Why?
Why?
When I get wrinkles.
What?
When's that going to happen? You don't make any faces.
Soon? I feel like my face is pretty animated.
That's not.
My eyebrows?
No.
Wait, look at me. Say something animated.
I mean, you can't just put me on the spot.
Yeah, say something animated. Just go, oh boy.
No, that's the actual animation.
Is that not what animated means?
Like, you know, like a really like expressive and alive.
Oh, say like, they hit the towers.
Yeah, say they hit the yeah, say they hit the towers.
No, here's the thing. I'm not getting canceled again this okay. week, but.
Well, it's a new week.
Yeah, it's a new week.
It's a new week by
it's
now.
It's a new week by now.
True, true, true. I don't know. I mean, I feel like I use my eyebrows a lot.
No, no, you don't.
I feel
no,
like I do.
You do not.
No, you don't.
I feel like I'm very
What does this have to do with Scoop being a hunter-gatherer?
Yeah, I'm confused.
Because you brought up Botox.
Which you have.
I don't have Botox.
You barely move your eyebrows. You barely move your face.
Though.
You move them up, like maybe a centimeter.
No, you do furrow the brows.
You furrow them
you
a lot.
You furrow them a
lot.
A
lot.
You furrow them a lot where I'm like a surprised lot. Where like you don't have wrinkles.
Yeah. It's actually amazing.
It is actually kind of like really cool.
It's
unless
honestly
you've been getting Botox for years.
It's pretty amazing.
I've only gotten filler in my lips.
Look up Frogan inflation for more.
Wait, but let's go back, guys. I want to know why you don't think Scoo would be a good hunter.
Oh,
don't.
No.
Stop
no,
that.
No.
Look, we're focusing.
Don't
we're dialing
on a stain
don't
that
ever
no
fixate
one sees.
On a stain that no one sees on your white shirt.
Stream
I would be a good
Mike.
Hunter. I can kill.
Sure. You'd be a hunter.
I think you would like the thrill of the hunt, but I think the actual hunt you wouldn't be good at.
What do you mean?
Like you'd be like, yeah, I'm gonna hunt, I'm gonna find these things, and I'm gonna kill them.
Yeah.
And then when it comes down to it, like the time to do it, you'd be like, I don't wanna
no,
do that.
No, cavemen, if we're saying caveman times, if we're speaking nowadays, now why would I do that? That's
right,
dumb.
Right.
But
right.
if we're going back like Stone Age,
I feel like you would be
a bow and arrow.
You would be in the cave playing super Ooga Ooga Bros.
I would not be playing Suga Uga Booga Bros. I was always a Sula La 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 kind of guy.
Oh, right.
Sula
right.
La La the varmint kind of guy.
Right. Dude, what would like a caveman theme park be? Like Ride the Mammoth?
Dinosaur USA. This exists. This exists already.
What's this called?
Dinosaur USA at Animal Kingdom.
Oh, you're right. Do you think Frog would be a hunter or a gatherer? I think Frog would be a gatherer, but she'd bitch about it all the time.
Can I be honest?
I think that'd be true.
Frogan wouldn't be either.
I think that'd be true.
No.
Why do you think I'd bitch about it?
Because who wants to be a fucking gatherer?
Who wants to be a gatherer, man?
You have bigger dreams. You want to be a hunter, but they won't let you.
No, why would I want to kill things?
Dude, hear me out. This is the
real
shit.
You're thinking of now. We're thinking of caveman times.
I feel like even caveman times, I wouldn't. I could barely eat chicken.
What?
Okay. Can I be honest? Dude, dietary needs during caveman times
is insane.
Dietary restrictions is insane. The fact that you think you have dietary restrictions during caveman times is crazy. That's insane.
No, but this brings up my point. Frogan wouldn't be a hunter or a gatherer. Frogan would figure out how to become the first matriarch of the cave people.
I think cave people had a lot of matriarchs. It'd be like a hive. Like a hive. Like the queen births the babies.
I thought it was like a king scenario.
Wait, so Frogan would be the queen in the situation?
Oh, yeah.
And Frogan, if it's caveman times, Frogan would be popping out babies for everyone.
Frogan would fucking kick down the stone circle door that they roll in front of the thing.
Yeah.
And she would just go, "It's time for a Frofest."
You know,
and she would kill the leader and she would become the leader.
You know what's crazy about caveman times?
What?
Is that the way we've portrayed caveman times throughout our life is that they had the strength to move a giant boulder in front of a cave.
Yes. Well, they did.
We didn't, though.
No,
there's no way.
We are the weaker man.
That's true. And you know why?
Why?
Dietary restrictions.
Mm-hmm. Fuck you, Frogan.
Dude,
this is what your ancestors' leadership led us to.
This is the craziest. The thing is that they would bring home like mammoth. They're like, "This is all we could find." And Frogan would be like, "I just won't eat money for a few days." Frogan, it's been 2 weeks. We haven't eaten for 2 weeks. We need to eat this meat. Otherwise, we'll die.
Throw it all out. I don't want it.
I'm dying.
I don't even want it in front of me.
Is there any of those like chickens? And then every caveman's like, "What the fuck's a chicken?"
She's the reason why why the dodos are extinct. She really fucked with Dodo back in the day.
She would go try to paint a petted saber tooth.
Yeah.
Oh, kitty! Just bites her leg off. Me, I don't know what I would be.
You'd be a hunter.
You think I'd be a hunter?
Oh, fuck. Dude, you're from Florida. Of course you would
be. Right. You're right. I would be the hunter.
Dude, of course you would be.
Yeah. If Capri was here, I think he'd be a gatherer.
That's a tough one.
He'd probably find a way out of both.
He'd be like the Iago of gathering. Like
he would sign on to do either job.
Mm-hmm.
He would do a thing for it and then just be like, "Okay, I need to sit down.
Yeah.
I'm tired."
Yeah, that'd be it.
I will never forget when we did the Hassan 3-point shot stream. And you and I, we were whipping up and down the court, getting all those balls. I was wearing
khakis, worst decision of my life.
That was the dumbest thing I've ever seen you do.
I didn't realize I'd be running that much.
But it always cracked me up. He did it for about 20 minutes and then just sat down the entire rest of the day. And he was like, "Man, we were on our feet for 12 hours." I'm like, "Capri, go."
So, yeah, let's get this started. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right.
How are we doing it?
Well, we'll just start off. I'll start off with Wallahi since he's not here. And then you do Wallahi.
Wallahi? Yeah. Okay. All right.
Wallahi.
Wallahi.
Welcome in, Habibis.
To another episode of the A-Raps podcast. Today we have Scoot replacing Capri because Capri's going through whatever he's going through.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, he's got a fair bit of anxiety.
Well, I didn't mean whatever as like a snide remark. He's like, he's going through something. I don't want to say what it is.
Yeah.
He's going through something.
He's struggling, but he'll be ready and back.
During our TwitchCon week.
During TwitchCon on Saturday at 2 p.m. 2 p.m.?
Yeah. No.
2 p.m.?
No.
What time is it?
11:45 in the
11:45.
Morning.
It's 11:45?
Yeah, we're early. We're like the first, not the first, but we're like the top of the hour.
Can I be honest?
What?
I'm not going to be awake for that.
Gonna be super hungover.
I'm gonna be hungover,
dude. That's great.
I'm not gonna be ready for that.
I love that for you, honestly.
And Frogan's gonna be hungover too.
I'm so excited for TwitchCon Scootishes, and I'm just like, I don't give a fuck about it.
It's Scoot thrives in that situation.
Yeah, I'm good at like social scenarios. Also,
he loves those people, and they love him too.
I hate like, everyone.
Why? Well, I know why.
Yeah, why?
Well, let's get into it.
Good question.
The last year, everyone exposed their true fucking colors and the monopolization of the streamer space. Don't care about anyone. I'm literally only there for the panel. I'm in a drag queen show on Friday.
That's cool.
And that's awesome. To meet the viewers.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Had I still lived in Michigan, I'd be really excited to see my dear friends Scootish raffle ticket and Caprice and Poppy. But I'm fortunate enough to see them mostly on a daily basis.
Yeah.
So it's just like the people I care about, I see them on a daily basis anyways. I see them often.
I always like TwitchCon because it is a way to meet new or strengthen old connections that you like have forgotten about.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just gonna list off a couple people.
Sure, dude.
Last year I had this amazing interaction with a streamer. I'm pretty sure she DJs now. XX Yikes.
Oh, I like Yikes.
Wonderfully kind person.
She's wonderful.
We're gonna hang out at TwitchCon. I'm really excited to see her again. Yeah.
Oh, she's coming.
Yeah, she's going.
Good. Where does she live? Does she live in, like, in Poland, or does she live here?
I don't remember. I don't know where she lives.
I don't know where she lives either.
I'm excited to see Krub. Krub lives in Michigan.
It's gonna be cool.
I'm excited to see a bunch of people that, like, just aren't around or not in the circle of people that I, like, fly around.
Yeah.
And it's, I always love just, like.
Do you fly around us because we stink? What?
No, you know, like, just, what's like, that? What's like that easy breezy, metaphor? Like, flying, you know? Like,
oh, I got you. Okay.
Yeah, just, like, chilling.
Yeah.
Like, it's just nice to, like, strengthen, like, random connections that, like, you're, like, oh, I don't think of you a lot, but when I see you, immaculate.
Right.
Like, great.
Yeah, I'm excited to have some of those if I do see them. I'm not really like going out of my way to see people.
Yeah.
I don't That's really. Fair. Yeah, I'm like, whatever, you know.
That's fair.
Yeah. A lot of these people I don't really even talk to on a daily basis or
I don't talk to them
at all.
No, exactly. So, and that's why it's like kind of like, nice. Okay.
But if I see you, I'm like, oh, cool.
Yeah. Excited.
Yeah. So I get it. I get the vibes. We're going to have a party hotel room.
Yeah, we are.
If you guys want to show up to our hotel room, you guys can. Hotel.
Bleep it, giraffe.
Yeah. The Republicans hate it.
Yeah. Good
did
luck
you call
finding
it,
a room.
Did you call the hotel?
No, I forgot.
Good-ish.
Oh, for what?
To get our rooms connected.
We want to get adjoined rooms so that Frogan can just walk through the door whenever she wants.
Like, hey, you have to call. I tried calling. They said,
I forgot.
Because you booked it through Priceline. He has to call. I even tried doing it from there. Like, what's the last four digits of the card? I'm like, I don't fucking know. I'm having him call.
Smart.
Yeah.
But was it smart, though? Because he hasn't done it. It's been 2 weeks.
He's been busy. He was literally in Austin. 2 weeks.
You did it on Monday.
You did it on Monday.
I did it.
You did it on Monday.
This last week has been
a whirlwind.
Rough.
It's been a long week. We all had really hard weeks.
Yeah. It feels like it's been 20,000. Yeah, but
it was a really long
week.
Or
whenever you check in. You have my information. Just tell them.
We need
a connecting room.
We need a connecting room, or I will.
Better to call earlier because then what if they're.
Yeah.
What if that room is
I'm
booked?
I'm throwing the toaster in the tub. I swear to God.
Yo, do we get toasters?
Maybe. I don't know.
If we get a toaster, it's
never
over
stayed,
for me.
I've never stayed in this hotel.
I thought we have.
No, this is a different hotel.
Oh.
This is a hotel. I've never stayed
Stop
in it.
Stop saying the name of it. We have to bleep.
Why?
Because. It's a public platform, and that's where we're staying. And it's coming out before TwitchCon.
These fuckers aren't going to see it.
No, it's okay. Just bleep it.
These fuckers aren't going to know.
Just bleep it.
These fuckers aren't going to
know. Am I insane?
No.
I understand why you're...
I can't tell what you're feeling right now because your face isn't moving.
It's the Botox.
It's the Botox.
Can I give you a sense? I'm an empath. I'm something of an empath.
Yeah, okay.
Let me get a sense for Frogan.
Yeah. Let me hear it. He's doing an ocular pat down a Frogan right now. Just make sure everything's good.
She's feeling jovial in that moment. However, a few moments before, she was not very.
Her bottom
with
lip
Scooty.
Is about to take over her upper lip. I don't know if jovial is
what. That's the lip filler.
I can't even move my lips like that.
Try it.
Wait, can you not?
Try it. Yo, so we got a liar.
Oh,
what else
are you lying about?
I'm not a powder.
Oh, a powder, like a powder. No, I thought she was like, I'm not albino, like powder. Remember that movie, Powder?
So no. Why'd you get so
what
offended
the fuck
by
are you
that?
Talking about?
I was confused. Powder, the movie Powder.
I have no idea.
Albino kid, he has like magic powers or whatever.
What?
Yeah, look it up. It's a good movie.
Dude, I wanted to be albino so bad growing up.
Okay.
What?
Why?
I feel like we've had this conversation before, but like I wanted to have purple eyes so bad.
Oh, that's
bad.
Right. Yeah, we have had this conversation.
What?
Yeah.
Why are you on your phone?
I was looking up the movie Powder.
I thought we're having a bleep it moment when they're just on their fucking phone.
No, I was looking up the movie Powder for you.
Are they on their phones a lot?
Yes.
Dude, I literally was just looking up the Powder movie so I could show you guys.
I was like, what's happening? I was like, are we losing the sense of the podcast
Dude,
right now?
I'm literally looking up the movie Powder so you guys could see the movie Powder.
Oh my God, it's a thing.
Yeah, it's a real movie.
That's crazy.
He's like, I think he's like.
He looks like Edward Cullen.
Well, he's not. He's Powder.
I feel like albino people aren't that white.
That's the whole point. It was a very bad yeah, movie.
You can tell it's a very bad movie.
It was very bad.
My man's awesome, looking though. Like young Darth Vader without the suit.
Yeah, exactly. Oh, speaking of Darth Vader, apparently Trump got shot again. Oh, wait,
I thought you were talking about James Earl Jones dying.
Yeah, that would have been a better transition.
I started to get so sad. And now I'm going to think, oh, he's sad about Trump getting shot. That makes sense.
No, dude, that would have been a better Scootish transition.
Scootish is the Jack Black of the podcast. Yeah, makes sense.
That's true. He is the Jack Black of the podcast.
Jablinski Games.
Dude, Earl Jones died, man.
Yeah, he died.
Yeah.
Now it feels undercut about the Trump situation.
It does feel undercut, and I feel bad. Well, that's what Trump does, dude. He takes other people's fucking glory away. And dude, yeah, Earl Jones died. It's
sad.
It's Voice really of generation. Sad. It was sad.
I don't know who the fuck
is your favorite James Earl Jones movie?
It was literally Mufasa.
In The Lion King.
In The Lion King. You know never that movie about the lions?
I've never seen The Lion King, but it wasn't
basically
like a favorite
Hamlet.
I said I've seen Lion King, but it wasn't like a favorite of mine.
What?
What do you mean, what?
What do you mean? What didn't you like about it?
Yeah, what didn't you like about it? Nala was a bad bitch.
It is one of the most perfect movies.
It was one of our sexual awakenings.
It was definitely a sexual awakening for me. In a weird way.
No, it was the right way. Especially hell at that yeah, age, brother. It was the right way.
Hell yeah, brother.
I was like, yeah, man, I'm really into lions, especially female ones. No, all right. So,
I didn't like that.
Sorry. Well, what don't you like about...
I don't like anything about it. It just wasn't one of my favorites growing up.
Why, though?
Just didn't like it
what
that much.
What was one of your favorites growing up?
The Nightmare Before Christmas.
Goth bitch.
Why, dude?
She hears all the Danny Elfman music and she's like, oh.
Dude, when we saw Danny Elfman live, she was like.
Wait, you saw Danny Elfman live?
Yeah.
When?
We told you this.
He was performing at Sick New World.
Oh. I forgot. Yeah. It's just, I think I, like most other people, hear Danny Elfman and they just go, oh, why?
Well, you don't like Oingo Boingo? You don't like Oingo Boingo?
I didn't know who the fuck he was until that day. What?
Nothing. I just...
You shot me a judgmental stare.
Yeah, because he does all the music for your favorite Disney movie.
I know, but like...
And for someone who's like, you know, for lack of a better term, obsessed with bands, you would think that would be something you would like look into.
Yeah, I know.
So...
Yeah, I mean, I liked all the weird movies growing up, like Corpse Bride, Nightmare Before Christmas,
Caroline. By the way. Yeah, yeah.
I liked all the Burton-esque films.
And Danny Elfman did most of his music. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So
now when we watched Beetlejuice,
Danny Elfman did the music on that too.
I was familiar.
Yeah, you're like, Danny. Oh, that's my boy.
I was like, oh my God, it's him.
He has red hair and weird nipples. That's my guy right
so
there.
He's so creepy looking.
No, but he's the voice of Darth Vader.
Oh.
And the voice of Darth Vader. So, like, pretty much every...
I think he was the only ever voice of Darth Vader.
He's the only ever voice of Darth Vader.
Official Star Wars voice.
Can it be replaced, though? Don't they use, like...
Well, now, I think they have been kind of, like, just taking his voice and then, like, you know, kind of replicating it.
With AI.
With AI. Or
they haven't.
Not with AI.
I'm joking.
With just other people.
They're just going to get a new guy.
Yeah. Or they're just not going to really use Darth Vader. I think it's time.
I want... Okay, I'm going to try to stay away from nerd conversations because I know Frodo's
not
into it.
Yeah, because I don't know what the fuck is happening right now.
I'm so fucking sick of the Galactic Empire saga of Star Wars.
I am too.
Move fucking past it.
Galactic Empires with all the white people, the stormtroopers and the armor.
Okay.
The original movies.
Yes.
I'm sick of it. Luke fucked years ago. Be done with it. Move the fuck on.
I agree.
Tell a different time period.
I want Old Republic. And Acolyte tried to do that, but like I didn't watch it. I heard it sucked.
No, you're falling for...
Is it good?
It's really good.
Is it really good?
It's not
good?
Like really good. It's just like...
They didn't get renewed for a second season, didn't they?
Yeah, because of the fucking race. This is a different problem on YouTube.
Yeah.
Every fucking Star Wars channel, the big ones, were supremely racist.
Yeah.
Homophobic. Really bad. Just because like the...
TV show had DEI,
mm-hmm.
and it did a lot of shit that like everyone has been asking for in Star Wars.
Yeah.
And people were just like not giving it a fair shake, not giving it a fair chance. Was it the best thing ever out of Star Wars? No. But was it fun? Yes.
Yeah.
Like, it's a good move.
I know they're too old for it now, and it wouldn't be the best move, but like even doing young Obi-Wan and Qui-Gon series where it's just them and their adventures, that would be sick.
No.
But they're too old. It wouldn't work.
I agree with you.
I hate you.
It wouldn't work.
I hate you.
Yeah. That camera is always going to go out. Anyways, so rest in peace, James Earl Jones. But you know who's thriving right now? Trump.
Insane.
Dude, all I'm going to say is Swifties are fucking insane. Swifties are crazy, dude. And you don't think somebody's a Swiftie until they pull out a gun on Trump.
Jesus.
It's the truth. They're crazy. I love them. Dude, Trump.
What are you talking about?
Trump tweeted, I hate Taylor Swift.
Okay.
Was it 12 or 20 minutes later?
10 minutes later.
I just got shot at. I just got shot at. Taylor Swift's fan base. You can't say you hate Taylor. They will come for you. They will find you.
I think what's...
As soon as she endorsed Kamala, they're like, all right, we got to kill him.
I think the funniest thing about the I hate Taylor Swift tweet...
Yeah.
Drafts, you put it up. I've tweeted this before.
What, that you hate Taylor Swift?
All caps. Same amount of exclamation points.
How many gunshots
points?
Whizzed by your head?
I didn't get any.
Oh, damn, dude.
I would just say skill issue.
Yeah, that's crazy. But apparently Trump got shot at today. It's alleged that he got shot at. Some witnesses are saying that they saw Secret Service shooting back.
Wait, what?
Yeah. This is on a golf course in Mar-a-Lago.
Oh, wait. Go back.
Okay, sure.
Is this real?
Yeah, this is real. Trump got shot at today.
Oh, I thought he was full of shit. I thought he was just saying shit to say shit.
No. Trump got shot at today.
Oh, that's real?
Yeah, for the second time. Well, it's alleged because they were saying, some news sources are saying that he was the main target. Other news sources are saying it was just in the vicinity, which could mean anything. It could mean that, you know, there was just guns going off. It's fucking Florida, dude. And Mar-a-Lago is where he was in West Palm is
If he's on a golf course, though, like.
But you could hear, but gunshots could be whizzing from anywhere. That's a golf course.
I don't know.
A lot of these golf courses are on residential areas.
Yeah.
So you don't know. You just never know. And it was a 50-year-old Hawaiian male. Whatever that means. I mean, anybody can be Hawaiian. I'm assuming they meant Polynesian, but I haven't seen any pictures of the guy.
They already got the guy.
Yeah, they didn't kill him. He ran away and they caught him on the highway on 95.
Dude, it was totally about him then.
You think so?
Yeah.
Well, the thing is.
Why would you run at that point?
Well, I think Secret Service notified the local sheriff or local police that mm-hmm. there was gunshots near the area.
Mm-hmm.
And think they pulled over the guy they think it is. Or maybe they saw the vehicle that got, I don't know. There's not enough information right now. But the thing is, that guy is still alive. So I'm sure we'll have some story from him.
Yeah.
About that. But twice, dude. And you know he's going to milk the shit out of this.
I don't think anyone's going to care.
I don't think so, too. He's going to milk it and no one's going to give a fuck. What do you think?
I think Trump's team watches Flagrant.
What?
Why?
What is that?
Because Schultz literally predicted it.
What is that show?
He literally said if Trump wants any chance of winning, he needs to get shot again.
Yeah.
What happens a couple days later?
Flagrant is that podcast with Andrew Schultz
mm-hmm.
And Akesh?
I don't know their names. I just know Akesh. Andrew Schultz.
And they, on their last podcast, said if Trump has any chance of winning, he has to get shot at again. Obviously, they're joking.
Yeah.
But it's just funny that came out and then Trump got shot at again. Allegedly.
I've been thinking about this because it's crazy that we live in a time where like
whatever.
a presidential candidate got shot.
Yeah.
But we live in a time where we let kids go to school and they are killed with guns and we don't care a couple days later.
Yeah.
Like
we're desensitized as a country.
It is horrible.
Yeah.
But why the fuck do I care if a 70-year-old man gets shot? I don't care if he's running for president. Like the fact that we let kids die and we don't think there's a larger gun issue in this country is absolutely insane.
They know there's a larger gun issue. They just don't give a fuck because they don't want to lose their guns.
And they're backed by gun companies.
Dude, Piers Morgan's had a great interview with some dumb idiot about this, where he was like flying to America and he had like Kinder eggs in his bag.
Yeah.
Those are banned in America. You can't get them.
Kinder eggs are banned here?
We still do have Kinder eggs, but they're not the real ones.
My mom sent some recently.
I don't like Kinder eggs.
Yeah, I know. I mean, they're real. We still have real ones here.
But like, they're banned because they're a choking hazard to kids. Can't get them. Like the ones in the UK.
You can't get them though.
What? What do you mean?
They're in Michigan.
You can get anything, but like they are, you can't fly in the country with them. How many cigarettes? They're banned. For all intents and purposes, they're banned. Right. They are. Like, I know they are. I know you can get them anywhere. You can also get like other fucking contraband anywhere.
It's true. You can get like, black market Kinder eggs is a crazy thing to go through.
It insane. But anyway, the whole point is like you can get that shit, but you can get a fucking bring a firearm in.
Yeah,
you like can just, that's yeah. crazy.
As long as you claim it, you can bring a firearm.
Yeah, like that's and insane. A and I'm not a huge Piers Morgan fan, but he kind of ate with that interview.
Did he?
Yeah, I don't have it. What?
I'm just checking.
Okay. Okay. Being sussy. It was just a crazy interview. Just very sad.
Piers Morgan?
Yeah.
I miss Capri.
Why?
I miss Capper.
Why?
Why?
He's a shithead.
Yeah,
Piers Morgan. I know he sucks. I agree that he sucks, but he ate in that interview. He had a good point. He like didn't let her get up. She kept trying to like argue with him, and he's like, no. He's like, what's the leading cause of death for kids? And they're like, oh, like she was trying to say like cancer, the flu, and he's like, no, it's guns. Like he's like, well, that's an
guns
opinion.
Guns are
like,
taking out more kids per capita.
He's like, it's not an opinion; it's a fact.
Yeah,
like. He did a good job. I know he sucks.
Yeah, Piers Morgan's not the best, but
he did a good job in that interview.
Good interview is a good
interview.
You have
to give props to like the worst person in the room.
A good interview is a good interview, dude.
Good interview is a good interview, man.
Some people think I suck. I think I do good interviews.
Do you want me to hate Piers Morgan?
No, I don't want you to have the same opinion as me just because with you.
But you kind of do because you said I'd rather have somebody else who wasn't you here.
You know what?
Keep
the Kinder eggs out. Let me have guns.
I mean, Capri's politically educated.
Okay. What did I say that was politically wrong?
The glazing of Piers Morgan.
He did a good interview.
It was a good interview.
He's not a good person, but he did a good interview.
I'll go with it, Scoot. If somebody gives a good interview, somebody gives a good interview, dude. You think James Lipton had a couple of bad interviews? He didn't, but that's fine. And you don't even know who James Lipton is, and that's fine.
I don't know who James Lipton is.
Inside the actor studio.
Oh, God, fuck that guy. Oh, he's so God. I agree with you, but yes, good reference. I forgot, dude. The amount of James Lipton interviews I had to watch. Oh my God,
I loved them.
I did too.
I really did. What? What's wrong? What's going on with this plant? What's in your brain?
Nothing.
Okay. Well, I need something to be in your brain. I need anything to
That'll be
in your
nice
brain.
That'll be a nice moment for Capri, though, that Frogan misses him.
Yeah, that is actually nice.
That's a sweet thing.
Do you miss him?
Not really.
Oh.
Wait, why are you going back on your word now? Do you think Swifties are behind this? Yes or no?
I mean, it's funny to imagine that like 50-year-old man is like a Swiftie.
Most of them are in hiding.
Huh?
Yeah. He's made more than one little friendship bracelet.
Apparently he had a GoPro on him too. And Taylor Swift was playing with the car in the car.
You're lying about the Taylor Swift playing in the car.
Misinformation is the best information, dude.
What, you're JD Vance now making up stories?
Dude, did you see that?
That is insane.
Did you see that?
You told me about it.
Dude, JD Vance apparently went on, I think it was CNN.
CNN.
Which is, oops. No.
Well, you have to, right?
He went on CNN and basically said he made up the whole story about
everything going on in Springfield,
everything
Ohio.
Everything going on in Springfield.
Yeah. Crazy.
Where the fuck even is Springfield, Ohio?
It's in Ohio.
And yeah, no shit, but dude, where?
Don't a
is
bunch
it
of yellow
Cleveland?
People live there?
I'm sorry?
Don't a bunch of yellow people live there?
What's that mean?
Like full yellow.
Like Asian
like
people?
Like The Simpsons.
Oh my God.
Was like, are you being racist
holy
right
shit.
Now?
You guys are fucked.
I thought you were being racist.
No, dude.
That's insane.
Why would you even think like that? You fucking racist.
Because Springfield, by the way, there's the most amount of evidence that it takes place in New Mexico. Dumbass. Two, Springfield is meant to be for any Springfield in any state, because every state has a Springfield, I believe.
Is it true?
Yes.
Is there a Springfield, California?
I think so.
Scoot, pull that up.
I'm Scoot.
Oh, Scoot. Scoot.
Producer Scooters wouldn't even pull it up for us anyways.
Dude, no one's even thought about Springfield. No one gives a fuck.
Yeah, I'm just like, dude, they're eating dogs, cats, and ducks.
Good.
And honestly, they're saying that, like, apparently they, like, grab the ducks and spin it around.
They're saying the Haitians are doing it. That's crazy.
There is a Springfield in California.
Is there really?
Yeah.
Fuck.
Dumbass.
I'm sorry about that. Oh, I'm sorry. But, dude, yeah, JD, we'll pull up the clip right here for you guys.
If I have to create stories so that the American media actually pays attention to the suffering of the American people, then that's what I'm going to do, Dana, because you guys are completely letting Kamala Harris
But J.D. Vance on CNN said, yeah, I made up the whole story.
Who was the reporter? Do you remember?
Oh, I don't know her name.
Damn it.
I don't watch the news.
Capri would have the name.
Capri would know.
Capri would know.
God, I miss Capri.
Look at us, all three of
but
us.
But do I miss him more than I miss than Frogan misses him? No. Frogan really misses him.
Frogan's really knees weak, arms spaghetti for Capri Sun Poppy.
Is that
right
a Michigan
now.
Reference?
I think so.
What's with the eyes? I can't really tell if you're happy or sad.
Did you hear what he said?
Hold on, empath.
Well, look at Scoot really quick.
I'm not looking at him. Did you hear what he said?
I can sense it.
You said your knees weak, arms spaghetti for Capri.
She's not happy right now. She does not miss Capri.
Knees weak, arms spaghetti for Capri. What did I miss?
No.
What do you mean?
For Capri, absolutely not.
You're not nervous for him?
No.
What does knees weak, arms spaghetti mean to you? What does that mean to you?
Infatuation.
Oh.
No.
No.
You can just
like
miss.
Nerves.
Yeah, you can just
yeah I'm not nervous for him. He gets nervous about every fucking thing. If that was the case, then I'd be so feeling that way 24/7.
You don't think as a good friend you should take away some of the nerves by being nervous for him instead?
How about you? Ask yourself that question.
I've been nervous for him for 4 years. It's your turn. Step up to the fucking plate, dude.
No.
Step up to bat.
Nobody steps up to bat for me whenever I'm feeling away.
What do you mean?
So why would I feel nerves about anxiety?
If you need to get out of the house, we get out of the house. And if you need to talk, Scoot talks to you.
Brogan, you call me rain or shine at any time, I answer.
Yeah, he answers.
What the fuck are you talking about?
You can't call me because I don't.
So, okay, you know what? We're airing shit out right now. Hey. Stop creating false narratives about your friends because they're so bullshit. And I'm like, I'm going to punch you.
What false narrative did I create?
Brogan, we are always there for you. Brogan, you called me at 1 a.m. and I stayed up till 4 to talk to you.
You stayed up an hour, but it was really nice.
Fuck off, it was an hour.
It was. I could pull up the phone call.
1 hour for the phone call, 3 hours for thinking about the phone call after it was over.
I had anxiety from the phone call. I didn't.
It was a bad day.
I didn't give a shit.
It was a bad day for me.
Frogan.
So there you go.
Nope, that's not the right phone call.
It was. Oh, is it not gonna I had tell anxiety me in the car, and I started crying on the way home, and you didn't even notice.
What? Wait, what happened?
I had an anxiety attack in the car and you didn't even notice.
When? Oh, that day? I noticed.
What the fuck?
I always notice.
Why didn't you say anything?
Because what am I going to say? Are you okay? Are you... that's for me, that's the last thing I want to fucking hear. Obviously not.
Honestly, that's not a terrible point.
If you want to have an anxiety attack, I don't want to be... I don't want to impinge on the sadness and the anxiety. If you need to let it out, let it out. If anything, you should feel glad that you feel comfortable enough having an anxiety attack in the car.
That's an insane thing to say.
Is that crazy?
I completely understand what you mean, because I hate bringing up my problems to say, like.
And if you're in the process of like going through it, I don't want to be like, what's wrong? What's going through it? And then you tell me, and then I am put in a position where I say something you don't want to fucking hear. That's not what you need. You don't need to hear anything.
That is a completely fair point.
Yeah. That also sounds very selfish the way I said
it does, but like, I understand what you're saying. You're saying like...
Anytime you cry or have a panic attack in the car, I notice.
What do you mean anytime?
It's happened a few times.
I felt so alone.
Well, I'm sorry about that. Okay. It was what do you want? What would you like me to do in that situation?
That day, I was just feeling so like sad and fucked up.
And you're like, nobody even sees me. Meanwhile, I'm here like, fuck, Rogan's crying.
Okay. I hear what you're saying because you are right. I don't like to be the cause of other people's like stress or anxiety, so I don't bring up my problems a lot.
Sure.
It's tough because like sometimes I don't know.
I don't like think I like to bring like I'll rant or whatever, but like when something's like genuinely bothering me, I don't really like to talk about like the deep shit. But like there are some days where I'm just like, fuck, dude, like I was really bothered that day.
Yeah, but you could just bring it up.
I think Raph needed a verbal signature that I you wanted to talk.
I did, actually.
But
thank you.
You wanted him to like just instinctively know he's not an empath like me.
No, but I am because I noticed and I knew.
No, but like you.
But I also don't harbor the same. I don't internalize feelings of others.
Sweetheart.
Yeah.
You noticed physical crying. I sense emotion. All right. All right.
Yeah.
We are not the same.
Yeah. Okay. Fair. Fair. Maybe I'm a shit person.
No, I don't. Because I understand. I understand what you mean. I understand what you're saying.
Also, we've been friends for a year now. What I've noticed is like sometimes she's just not feeling good. And so maybe it was just that. She could have had a bad chicken nugget. It could be anything.
A bad sandwich sans the sandwich. Dude, yeah. Sans the bread.
Yeah, no bread, no
and a
sandwich.
Side of mashed potatoes. No sandwich.
The mashed potatoes were bad. They were too great, like milky, whatever.
The lactose
she had cheese and didn't have lactate. It could literally be anything.
Ew.
What do you mean, ew?
No lactate.
She doesn't take lactate.
I've never had it.
And she's lactose intolerant and eats cheese regularly.
I love it. I love it.
I sent her an ad for Milky.
I like the birth control looking lactate.
I think that would be good for you.
I was like, ooh, crazy. It looks so cute. What? It looks better than this stupid ass ugly packet.
You're right.
Like the Purell packet. It looks like a Purell packet.
You're right.
Yeah, if you think I don't notice when you're having these attacks, I know.
I just don't want to do anything.
I know 99%. I just don't want to do anything.
But again, I know what you're saying. You're like you're just like giving her the space to like see how she feels when she wants
flush
to,
it out.
When she wants to bring it up,
I'm there.
She'll bring
I'm
it
literally
up.
Right there. I can't go anywhere.
Maybe in the future.
Uh-huh.
How about you try to verbalize it.
The glasses position, but then, to taking it like not even off your face. Crazy.
But then maybe next time, Rafi.
Just say something.
You just should just say something.
Should I just say something?
Comfort her to let her know that she's not alone.
Okay. I can do that.
You don't have to do all this.
Well, listen, I'm going to now. Now that I know that you know, don't think that I know listen, that you're having anxiety listen, attacks in the car.
Grab her arms from the steering wheel and say, no, don't, no.
I can join with my knees. Hold on.
No, just whisper, Jesus will guide us. And Jesus will take that fucking wheel.
Dude, I remember
if
that
she's
day.
Having a panic attack, the thing I'm going to do is I'm going to get as close to her face as possible and be like, what's wrong? Are you okay?
Are you okay?
Are you good? Dude.
No, dude. I was having a panic attack like majority of the way home. And then I took the wrong exit. I'm like, yeah, I was there for fucking handle it anymore.
Yeah, I was there for all of that. I was in the car. Believe me, I know. I know. Well, I don't know why you think that I don't know.
You didn't
I know.
Say anything.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
Yeah, but
I understand all sides. Just fucking say something next time.
Well, now I know. I will.
Yeah, okay, great.
Yeah, great. So, when's your next panic attack going to happen? So I can put this
schedule. We got to make sure Raph's free.
Am I dramatic, though?
About what?
What? What do you
Wait,
mean?
Dramatic about
That's
what?
A loaded question.
Yeah, I mean, yes, but is it something
yes,
specific?
In this situation.
Oh, no.
No, if you're having an anxiety attack, you're having an anxiety attack. You're dramatic in thinking that I don't fucking know that you're having it.
Didn't think you noticed.
Yeah, I always notice.
You are dramatic.
I know.
I know I'm dramatic, though.
Yeah.
You are dramatic.
I do think sometimes you as a person have a hard time saying, I'm upset. You don't have to tell us why. You can just say, I'm upset. And that's okay.
Yeah. But if you think that I can't see that you're upset, then
You're stupid. You're a stupid bitch.
Fucking dumb idiot.
Fucking stupid.
Fucking dumb fucking bitch.
I don't know. I guess because I was like,
what time are we out on these cameras? Sorry.
No, you're fine. Because I feel like I'm a very observant person. And like, if somebody is like,
oh, 40 minutes, but they're all still recording.
Well, the A64s are all recording.
No, they're literally all recording.
Are we
even
not using
the 6000?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
It's the 6000.
It all says REC. It all says REC.
What about this one over here?
It says REC. It says REC. This one's only going for 19 minutes.
Oh, okay, then we're good.
Oh, yeah, because that one kept shutting off.
Do you want to just reset them all just right now?
Yeah, sure.
Really quick?
Yeah.
Because the A's, this is not what we're talking about.
No, I was
the A6000, the A61s and A64s, they don't have a limit.
Are we using a regular 6?
We're using the 6 on me, but that's all that matters.
Yours kept fucking up, so.
Okay, cool.
No, but what I'm saying, I feel like I'm a very, very observant person, so if I can notice, like, a vibe switch, like, and I guess I vocalize it, like, right off the bat, like, if I notice something, like, somebody's, like, quiet, or, like,
yeah,
their vibe is different, I'm like, are you good?
Yeah, but the problem with that is that sometimes it's just nothing.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, there was a day where, to strengthen Raph's point, when I was just having like an off day, I didn't really want to talk about it. I just wanted to kind of exist.
Yeah.
And you kept coming up to me and asking like, what's wrong? I'm like, I'm fine.
That happened yesterday.
Yeah. He yelled at me.
Kind of a little bit.
Raffy, why did you yell at her?
Cause I was chilling. I was having such a good time. I was having a really good time. And I kept hearing, are you okay?
I asked it
twice.
Are
you good? And I was like, yes. Oh, the first time I was like, yeah, I'm good. Nothing's wrong. And then the second time I'm like, yes, I'm fine.
He just looked off.
I get it. No, you know? I get it.
And I just
we were
vibing, dude. The whole we were doing crazy shit. I literally drank Java Monster out of Java Monster cups after playing beer pong with them.
Ew.
Yeah, it was bad. We did it for a photo.
Java Monster's gross.
You see, you're like the fucking star of the reel.
Do you really like it?
Oh, was I really?
Yeah, I got tagged in it. Hold on, I got tagged in it.
I didn't see it.
Hold on.
My brother, Michael was like, I want them to take a photo of me so bad, but they just kept coming up to me instead of him.
I guess my
issue
is,
can I be honest?
Yeah.
You're more photogenic.
Yeah, thank you. And I'm not balding.
Don't be mean, Jesus. Michael. I just guess kidding. My issue is, I'm like,
you want to make sure everyone's having a good time because then you think it's something in the environment or maybe you did something, but it,
you called
I'll tell
me
you
eight
right
minutes
now,
ago?
I'm fucked up. I was trying to call you out for being a liar.
I was like, when did that happen? I was like, okay.
I was trying to call you out for being a
no,
liar.
No, I don't know. I just like, if vibes feel off, I just want to make sure the person is okay.
Yeah, 100%. But that's not your responsibility.
It's, I know it's not my responsibility, but I want people to
but
know
I
that
I appreciate it.
But I want
I really
people
do.
To know that I care about them.
It's the same thing. Like your vibe was a tad off today. And I asked you like, what's wrong? And you were like, nothing.
Yeah.
Honestly, I am on edge today, but like, I don't know why.
But okay. We all know why.
Well, you didn't, but like that's really that.
We,
like
we
you,
know,
you,
we
you
know
didn't
why.
Want to say anything. And
know.
I'm calling you out on a public podcast now.
Yeah.
I have to talk about it.
No, she doesn't
I'm a little
talk
bitch.
About it.
No, no. I'm just on edge.
No. I understand.
It's because TwitchCon's coming up and we have stuff to do.
Oh, TwitchCon's. I'm excited.
Where the fuck did it go?
Are we booking like people to come on?
I want to do that today.
Dude, we don't even have the fucking. I have to build. Can I rant?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I had to build this stupid fucking tier list thing. And
well, that's what
I
wanted today to do.
How to build. Like, I have to build it. I don't have the tiers that we're going to do because with what we're doing, it doesn't make sense to take the ones that already exist.
Yeah.
Because it's not like a slur. If we're doing, who could say Arab? Could have ripped it. You know, could have ripped it easy.
Why don't we do that?
But even then, it's like,
what do you want it to be?
I want it to be whatever anybody else wants it to be. I just want to have guidance so I can build it. That's all I want.
That's what today was going
to
be.
This is your creative guidance. You get to decide.
We're doing that today. After we record, we're just going
to.
Huh?
I want to clothes recording. I want to go clothes shopping.
Oh, we'll do that too. What is this?
You.
Are we going to show this or no?
Yeah.
Ew. I put that in my mouth. What is? Oh, yeah. 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 Hassan got a feature on that too. I'm wearing his merch.
Oh.
Send it to Hassan. Be like, dude, look, you're a Java monster.
Wait, why was I on the pizza box?
You know,
I thought the same thing when I saw it.
Yeah, what the fuck? I did not okay that likeness. I better get my fucking money.
We'll put the video up here for you guys to look at.
Oh, I love Chris was there.
I like how they like take everyone a creeper shot of you. Oh. Yeah. Like zoom in creeper shot and then.
Hell yeah.
Yeah, dude.
Playing beer pong with Monster is diabolical.
It was diabolical.
For someone's heart, that is like terrible.
The cookie had alcohol in it.
Did it really?
Yes. Ew.
Well, Salon, that's not good. Haram.
Haram. Rogan's a drunk.
I was like wondering why the cookie tastes so good, and that was a lot.
And it was in the frosting. I was like, damn, the frosting's fucking amazing. No, but to circle back to the point, no, my close friends are great friends.
What?
My close friend, the whole point, you're like, you're throwing your friends under the bus.
What?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, because you say, like, I'm alone, no one cares about me. And yeah, I'm glad we went back to this. You're still a stupid bitch. You're still dumb. I still hate you for this.
No, but the point is, no, my close friends are great friends. The ones here and the ones back in Michigan. I love them all.
Fuck you.
But the one thing I'm not going to do is internalize Capri's constant anxiety to be a good friend.
That wasn't the conversation.
That was not the conversation.
You're
mouthing conversations together.
The conversation is when you say dumb shit. Like, we don't care about you or we don't want to do what you do.
You did say that.
I didn't say that today.
You did say that today. But you said it historically and it's insane. It's insane because we love you and we go out of our way to help you and do things.
I'm sorry I have mental illness and anxiety. I'm sorry I have...
Well, now you're making me look like the asshole.
I'm sorry I've actively tried working...
I'm not going to internalize your mental illness.
I'm not asking you to.
No, I think... I'm just doing the...
I think the way it started was like, don't you want to... Like, you should... Something about feeling the way Capri...
You should fuck. Me you like should that. Fuck what?
No.
I didn't say anything about fucking.
None of this had. Frogan, I like promise you, none of this had to do with Capri.
This had nothing to do with Capri.
Giraffe?
What?
Raph, what?
Don't point
what
at her.
What are you pointing? What?
What if I want to point at her?
Don't point at her. She's my friend.
I've known her longer than you. And my employee.
At Scoot and Ticket Productions.
Yeah.
Hire us now.
Yeah, dude. Anyways, it's fucking Swifties, right?
Fucking Swifties.
Dude, I love Taylor Swift. I used to love Taylor Swift. Fuck that bitch.
Well, don't say that because then we're going to get shot.
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
I don't want to get shot.
Talk shit, get shot. I saw now. Ice. Who's the one in Law & Order?
Ice-T. Oh, that's Ice-T.
I saw Ice-T live one time.
Yeah, it's probably terrible.
He brought his dog out. He was like, talk shit, get shot.
And then he killed the dog?
No.
Did he eat it?
Mm-mm.
That JD Vance got me all fucked up. He's got me all fucked up.
Dude. But apparently because of the whole cat debate thing, apparently a city in Texas, like people are going around killing the feral cats and just leaving their corpses everywhere.
Oh my God.
And then.
And what protest?
To prove the point of immigrants. They're saying that people are killing the cats on the street to like show that like.
I was just in Texas. I did not see any cats.
Dude, if I.
I think they killed them all.
Here's the thing.
Oh my God.
Here's the thing, like, whenever I can't deal with seeing dead animals at all.
Well, that's why they eat them so that you don't have to look at it.
Pleasure. No, dude, like, I'll never forget, like, on my way to in undergrad, I drive on the freeway, I see a dead dog, I'd cry the entire way to school.
I know, we drove past a bushel of cows on a trailer, and started crying. And I was like, our friend is in the backseat dying, and you're here internalizing cow's pain instead of your friend in the backseat.
Mer.
Oh
no.
No, I don't know. I love animals, but it's just like, and then I saw like a police footage of, I don't know if it's real or not, so don't like quote me on it. They're like, she has fur and blood around her mouth. She definitely ate one of the cats.
It's you talking about in Springfield? That one.
I think
Black lady. She is not an immigrant. She's a resident, and I think she was a meth head or something. She did not eat an ant, and she was so she was just. I don't know if she didn't do anything to an animal. She just killed it, I think, or something like that. But I know she's not an immigrant. I think she's a resident of Springfield.
It's just perpetuating weird fucking stereotypes. Oh,
yeah, dude. It's just it's a snowball effect.
Yeah.
And all this because this guy just doesn't want people to talk about him fucking a couch.
He's so weird.
Dude, what a weirdo.
I don't like him.
Couch fucking. See, I've seen that meme, but I never like delved into it.
In his book, he talks about his whole chapter. Well, you could see in chapter 12 of my book, did the softer the couch, was the like easier a kid the plow. Or something? Huh?
Or did he fuck it in adulthood?
I don't think it matters.
He's still fucking the couches.
I don't think it matters.
You know damn well he's out here still fucking couches just to reclaim youth.
We're fucking a couch, shooting heroin, playing controversial things just for the hell of it.
Saying Haitians eat dogs.
And cats and dogs. Start with misdemeanors.
All I'm saying, if a bunch of Haitians immigrated to Springfield, Ohio, the whitest place on the world, that place is going to be pretty fucking cool.
I was going to say Muslims need like a stereotype, but we already have one.
What?
We're all anti-Semitic.
Well, that's one of the maybe like 20 stereotypes
I want like a good one.
You fuck goats.
I want an even better.
I could give you like 9 or 11 good ones, probably.
All right, let me hear it. Oh, that was good. That was good. That took me a second. That was good. That was real good.
What do you mean?
I don't know. I want a good one.
What's a good one? What's a good racial stereotype?
Yeah.
I was just saying one that people don't.
Top 10 racial stereotypes. I was just
saying one that people don't believe, but they believe the cat, dog, and duck eating. Like, what's a racial stereotype for, like, Arabs that's so, like, what the fuck? That's definitely not real.
We build tunnels and live in them. 9/11.
Damn.
That happened, like, one time.
Yeah. And then the goat fucking is a big one.
I got called a goat fucker in a Walmart parking lot before.
Good. Deserved.
I cried.
Yeah, that sounds like it would suck.
Deserved.
You know what made me cry about it, though?
What?
People were watching this fat man with, like, a car. Like, his car didn't even have windows. It had cardboard boxes over it. Calling me a goat fucker and telling me to go back to my country. Nobody intervened.
Yeah, bystander effect.
I know. I was just, the bystander effect's kind of crazy. Now, if this would have happened to me today.
9/11 too.
My mouth would have been a fucking weapon. No.
Why? What are you doing with that mouth?
A lot of things.
We need to suck them off. No. What the fuck? What are you doing, dude?
No.
What do you say?
Brogan, I've heard the shittier the car, the bigger the dick. That might be a battle you're not willing to fight.
No, he wouldn't deserve to have his dick sucked by me. I meant like
that's royalty. Yeah. Mouth right there.
Yeah. My words would have been weapons.
What would you have said?
Dude, listen.
You would have started it off with that?
Dude, listen.
Dude,
I would have fought his ass.
What would you have said?
What would you have said?
You dumb fat incel looking ass bitch.
Well, you can't use words he doesn't understand.
He definitely knows what incel is. He was a Reddit mod 100%.
Dude, I think the internet has broken you. Not many people know what incel means.
Yeah.
I mean, I've been terminally online ever since I was 12 years old.
I've been to like bum fuck America now.
Do you think my mom knows what an incel is?
No.
Can I call her?
No.
Why?
No.
I miss her.
No, you don't.
We can talk to her after the podcast. Right now, this is about us.
I miss my mom. I don't talk to her.
When did you find out what incel was?
Recently, like 2 years ago.
No, incel I found out like 2 or 3 years ago.
You know what the internet has perpetuated?
What?
What?
People being insecure about their hairlines.
Oh my God, dude. I'm not even joking. Last night, there was a game that Austin and Cinna played. I'm the producer for In the Tub with Austin show, if you guys don't know that already. But they measured their foreheads, and Austin, the rest of the night, was freaking out about his hairline.
Yeah, dude. Like,
it's insane.
Because I started watching Twitch in 2018, and like Hassan's hairline became like a topic of like concern, like to the point where he got on like finasteride and minoxidil to like save his hairline and shit like that.
That's crazy, yeah.
And I'm just like, and you see it common amongst like other streamers and like in streamer communities, like people always point out the size of people's foreheads.
Yeah.
Yeah, dude.
And I was like, damn, like, even I got insecure about my fucking hairline. I'm like, I don't need to be insecure about my hairline. I would show it, but my forehead is dyed because I dyed
it. I don't know what your hairline even is.
It starts right here.
That makes sense.
Be fucking real.
I am being real.
You've seen my hairline before.
No, I have not.
Yes, you have. Nope. Yes, you have.
I have not. I don't look.
Yes, you have.
No, I haven't.
I still think you got Raggedy Ann hair.
Well, you saw her fucking weird bush thing that you pulled out of her car.
It was red.
Don't pull it out.
I don't want to see it.
Haram! She just pulled her extensions out. She pulled her extensions out.
You don't need to show me your fucking Raggedy Ann fucking college liberal phase. You dyed it purple. Very alternative.
They're called fairy
bitch.
Strands. They're fairy strands.
All right. Whatever. All right. What? Next, you're going to say men don't deserve rights? Okay. College liberal. Dyeing that hair fucking purple.
You shove it back in there?
Yeah, oh. I have to put it back on my ponytail. And if I do God. That, it's fucked up.
Jesus Christ.
But ew, no, I'd never dye my hair purple.
I know, I was just playing with the joke that I think your hair is Raggedy Ann.
So many of our friends dye their hair purple.
Who's our friends?
I guess you're right.
There's people we know.
I don't know anyone sure. with dyed hair right now, I don't think.
Here's the thing. I mean,
Doug has dyed hair.
Does he?
Blonde? Is it still blonde?
Oh, it might be.
Yeah.
Growing up, I used to dye my hair a lot.
You still do?
No, I don't. I just started dyeing it again recently, black.
You've been. I feel like you dye it all the time.
I touch on my roots.
Don't believe her. Look up Raggedy Ann. Mm-hmm. It's Frogan.
Bro, Gapped says I look like Ice Spice under my hijab.
That's basically Raggedy Ann. So I kind of nailed it. I got there. I was right.
My mom hates when I dye my hair black.
Why? What does she want you to be?
She's like, you're too pale for that hair color. You look ridiculous with it.
Oh, like the Grudge?
No, I'm not even that pale. You and your sister look ridiculous when you dye your hair black. You guys are too pale for it.
You sure you miss her?
I do miss her.
You sure you miss her?
I mean, I told her, I'm like, you're just being a hating ass bitch. Sorry I look good with my black hair. Everyone looks good with black hair. That's a lie.
I would not look good with black hair.
No, you would not. Absolutely not.
I'd look like little Harry Potter.
Yeah, you would.
I feel, Expecto Patronum.
Yeah.
I feel like most people look good with black hair.
You look like a
Hermione,
Tom
why don't you
Hanks.
Come give my wand a little suckle?
Tom Hanks in Polar Express, I feel like you would look like.
Oh, I do look like that when I have a mustache.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I will say, I feel like I could pull it off because I have dark eyebrows.
Yeah.
I don't think you don't pull it off.
I can we don't know. You, black you don't hair. Know. But I can picture you with black hair.
It, yeah, you just be have black hair.
My scar.
Now, if you were now, if now, oh, never mind. I have
no,
nothing
say,
to say.
No, say it. I'm curious.
Say it, bitch.
No, I was gonna say.
I'm curious, Gaffy.
Don't
tell
make
me.
It too black, because then JD Vance is gonna say your hair's eating dogs and cats. So that's what I was going to say, but it didn't come out right. So maybe it's a good thing you're not showing your hair.
Disappointed in you, man. You used to stand for things.
Now I sit.
I love it.
What do I stand for, Scoot? What do I fucking stand for?
You stand for everything.
TwitchCon 11:45 A-Rab's podcast live.
On Saturday in the Give Please Theater, I think.
We still have no information about what's going on. Dude, I don't want to complain about it right now.
What do you
now.
Mean? What don't you know that's happening?
I just don't know what exactly we're getting. I wish I had a little bit more information.
I mean, we can do Friday. Walk to the room and let's scope it out.
You're absolutely just getting a table with microphones.
Yeah, it's going to be exactly how we did it.
But they said it's a theater, so I was like, it's fucking that's, me up that's, mentally.
That's room classifications.
Oh yeah, fuck
yeah.
That then.
And they usually and if they're doing it the same way as TwitchCon,
Vegas.
If they no not Vegas, San Diego 2 years ago, each room has their own designated stream.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, so that's why I'm like confused. Like, yeah. So then what
oh,
are we getting?
Really? Is it not just live on someone's channel?
No, we could do. Oh my god, my.
It should just be live on your channel.
It could be live on our channel, but it's also they also have like the Give Please Theater, stream and like all that.
Yeah.
Where they usually live stream it, but we don't have any of that information.
Dude, we got to do something crazy. Something crazy, like something crazier than like the.
Can we tell them? No.
We should do something. We should do
don't
something.
Worry. Don't,
dude, it's
don't.
Been eating me alive. Not telling you.
I want to do something so crazy. Raph. I want to be better than the VMAs this year.
Don't worry. I can't tell you what's happening, but I know something will happen. You will get a Dexterity.
Am
article.
I getting? Am I getting? Am I getting shot at?
No.
Well, then yes. I don't give a fuck. I want to get shot at.
No.
You will get shot at.
Oh yeah, dude. What would I even do in that situation?
Duck? Would you use me as a human shield?
Oh, you're right. Huh?
Would you use me as a human shield?
No, dude. I would never grab somebody and put them in front of me. If anything, I would just run up to the guy. me, I'm ready. me, dude. Fuck, man.
I miss Jerry and Sydney.
Our security guards. They were so great.
They loved us.
Drum up some controversy.
Well,
what do you think just happened the last week, Scooty?
Do it harder.
Really dive into it.
Bleep it up. Bleep this out. I'm gonna.
And we're back. Hi, everyone. Welcome back to the A-Rabs podcast.
Yeah, that was a bars and tone moment for sure.
Yeah.
Definitely bars and tone.
We'll get the little fucking Eric Andre, like, boom, bump, bump, bump.
You know, I don't want to steal his stuff.
Dude, I'm pissed.
Why are you pissed?
But he won
a Grammy. Why are you pissed?
Andre 2000?
What? What did you just say? Talking about a fucking TV show. What did you just say? What stupid ass shit did you just say? Andre 3000, like the fucking Classic 3000 Cartoon Network show?
I can't believe that's what you know him from. That's crazy to me.
No, I know.
He's a musician.
Yeah, I know he's from the band too. I don't know what band or group, but I remember. I know
Outkast. Andre 3000.
Outkast, thank you.
Oh, yeah, I forgot the name.
Yeah, I know that, but like
I can't be here.
No, we were talking about a TV show.
Wait, how am did I you the say culture? Eric Andre? Wait,
Eric Andre.
Is that the comedian?
Yes.
The funny one.
Why are you crying?
Yes, the funny one. Why are you crying? Are you okay?
Is that funny? Hey.
You are having a good
Hey, are you alright?
You okay? Don't touch me.
You okay? Are you alright?
You okay?
What's wrong?
What's wrong? Scoot, are you okay?
Freaking
Scooter,
what's wrong?
Stop.
Raph, I'm not okay.
What's wrong, Scoot? Raph,
can I be honest?
What's wrong?
I'm not okay because my friend Frogan's not okay.
What's wrong, Frogan? Are you okay?
Stop.
Frogan, are you having
Frogan, what's wrong?
Get off me.
Frogan, I'm not on you. I'm just
You're touching me.
I'm not touching you.
What's wrong?
I'm not touching you.
Get him off me.
Did Frogan, I do it right, though?
I'm not touching you. Frogan, I'm not touching you.
No, you didn't get close enough.
I'm not touching you.
I couldn't.
I'm not touching you, Frogan. I'm not touching you.
Why did you actually touch her? Dude, what the fuck? Why'd you
show her
touch
that
her?
I'm powerful?
He touched my face.
I did.
Why'd you do that?
I don't know.
Oh, is Eric Andre the one that did like that silly dance that one time?
Show me the dance.
I can't do it. I'm not sassy.
We'll try it enough. No, hold on. Get up.
No.
Do it.
Frogan,
no.
we've done so many dances for them.
Please do something.
For them, do it.
Stand up and do the dance.
It's too sexy. I can't do it.
What sexy dance?
I don't think Eric Andre has ever been called sexy.
I don't think so either. Well, he's dating. Who's he dating right now?
I don't know.
I think I'm thinking of the wrong person.
I think you are too.
I need to look it up. Where's my phone?
Okay. Well,
hold on. It'll take me 2 seconds.
No. While she's looking that up.
I think the apple's rotten right to the core.
Dude, I saw Brett do that today.
How cringe
was
that?
Crying.
Who?
Cinemarxist.
Brett.
Oh, I was like.
Dude, Brett and I have been becoming very good friends recently.
Good.
It's been nice.
Good. I like him.
Yeah, we've been gaming and.
That's good.
We've been talking.
Dude, there's one comedian that did a dance that everybody freaked the fuck out over.
But who was it?
Oh, that was Ludwig with the Luddy.
Ew, no. It wasn't him.
It wasn't him.
I said sexy.
The Luddy's pretty hot.
So now you didn't even like find it? Get up and do the dance.
No, I'm not.
Okay.
It's okay. Like him like rubbing like.
I'm tired of me and scooping the wild cards on this podcast. We need you to get up and start dancing and stuff.
You dance then, bitch.
I don't know what you're fucking talking about.
Don't yell at me like that.
Why?
Don't yell at me like that.
I don't know what you're talking about. Is that better?
No.
I don't know what you're talking about. I don't know what you're talking
That's
about.
Better. That's
I don't
better.
Know what you're talking about. Why would I go up and dance and just dance? It doesn't prove anything.
Make it sexy.
No, it doesn't. But I don't know what it is.
What if we do the apple dance on our knees?
No.
No.
Been there, done that. Move on.
The apple dance on your knees?
Yeah.
I don't need to be on my knees. I want to be on my
knees.
We
do because.
Yeah! And I'm going to let it happen. I'm going to let it happen. I'm going to be in the room watching, eating pop chips.
That might happen.
I'll watch.
You could come to my
room.
Dude,
I'm so fucking sad.
No, I'm watching. And I'm inviting you to come watch, too.
You're invited.
Dude, it's a
Thank
it's
you
a,
so much.
It's an A-Rab
You're welcome.
Event.
Thank you.
You're welcome. You're invited to the Kuehl. We have Kuehl brunch at 11. Don't miss it.
Smell. That's going to be awful.
One of my best friends was supposed to come to TwitchCon and he bailed last minute.
Oh, what a fucking piece of shit.
Nah, he just doesn't have enough money. I get it.
Yeah, get rich, dude. Sorry. Yeah,
it sucks. It's a bummer, but you know.
That's rude. Scoot's talking.
It's fine. She was doing the dance.
But not the sexy one she was talking
about.
No,
she wanted to do the dance. She did a dance.
She did the apple
dance. I don't think I'm capable of sexy dancing, to be honest.
Well, you don't know until you try.
Can you I be honest?
Singing the blues and you did that
any
fine.
Any dancing is sexy.
Yeah, man. I like that.
The worm?
Yeah, yes. Sexy. Have you, seen Scotty, have you ever seen Scotty Too Hottie do it?
Dude.
Can you do the worm?
No.
No,
and I won't do it for you.
Dude, the worm. If you see someone doing the worm
until
good,
you get up and do the sexy dance and tell me who
dude,
you're talking about.
Dude, the worm's hot, man.
The worm's hot. Also, I can't do the worm that much because of my testicles.
Yeah.
I wish I had testicles.
No, you don't.
You guys make it seem so like.
No. Here it comes. So like
make
what?
Make it seem like what? Awesome.
It
it's
is.
Not you debilitated.
Dude, imagine just having a
guy
fucking,
who usually sits in this chair.
You know what came on my feed the other day?
What?
Movie 43, that scene with Hugh Jackman. I don't know. I was like, why is this recirculating?
I'll be honest, so many people hated on that movie.
I
I'm
love
like,
that
it's,
movie.
It's
a great
silly.
One.
It's just fun.
It's just
silly.
Skits, dude.
Yeah.
Stupid shit.
Let him be have fun and be silly.
The fact that Hugh Jackman was like, yeah, mate, you can put balls on my chin. That's great.
What happened?
It's a movie. You wouldn't get it.
In this movie.
You wouldn't get it.
Obviously, I'm asking because I don't get it, so I'm asking you to explain it to me.
In this movie.
No, hold on. She wants me to explain it.
Okay. Sorry.
You wouldn't get it.
Nailed it, man.
You sure you miss Capri? It's basically a movie of just skits with all these like A-list celebrities. And they're like the most ridiculous, crazy. Like there's a scene where Chris Pratt and Anna Faris are.
This was back when Chris Pratt was cool.
Yeah. Anna Faris wanted Chris Pratt to shit on her chest. And that was like one of the skits.
Insane that you chose not to explain the one you were explaining originally.
There's also another one where Hugh Jackman's like this big famous guy. And
like
he's
Hugh
on a
Jackman.
Date. He's like Hugh Jackman. And he's on a date with this woman. But the thing is that Hugh Jackman has testicles on his neck. Like actual like balls. And she's just like, is anybody seeing this or?
Everyone's acting
normal. And everyone's
about
acting
it.
Normal. Like it's just whatever. That one scene where he's like, there's a scene. Okay. Am I boring you?
No. I'm hearing the slurshing around of the ball.
You can slurshing. Hear
that? Well, I'm trying to listen to
the
you.
Slurshing.
You can hear this.
Yes.
She has super hearing.
That's crazy.
She has the new AirPods just always in her ears. The Actis hearing aids.
It, dude.
Speaking of hearing aids, the VMAs this year, man, they sucked.
What the fuck was that transition?
I'm trying to transition, dude.
You guys can you do it better?
I'm like Donald Trump transitioning, okay?
You guys can just transition. You don't
because
need
because I'm an illegal
you
immigrant.
Just, you can just
the immigrants are coming to this country.
This is something that like I sit and watch all the time. I'm like, why are they doing it like this?
Doing like what?
Why are you guys trying to do like a sweeping like? Well, time to talk about a new thing. Just start talking.
Pootie told me that you have the best transitions.
Huh?
Pootie told me you have the best transitions.
Well. Look who it is. If it isn't the little fucking bitch boy from Bitch Town.
Who said that?
Her friend Pootie.
Pootie.
His has the name Pootie.
Well,
name.
Okay, his name is King Potato, but Pootie.
Dumbass. Fucking stupid. Just start talking.
I just think like culture nowadays is just not like
we need
as exciting.
We need to hook him. And pull them in.
How are we gonna hook them?
You're the hook, honey.
I'm the fucking hook, yeah. Dude. This is a lot of responsibility on me, and I feel like I already have too many responsibilities.
I tried.
Do you want to try to hook?
Yeah, I can try.
Yeah, try a hook.
Speaking of sexy dancing.
No, that happened a long time ago.
No, wait. I want to see.
Where does it go, though?
I want to see where it goes.
Okay.
Katy Perry scissored somebody at the VMAs.
See, that would have been a
wait,
really
what?
Good transition.
Whoa. What? Tell me more.
Yeah.
She was performing a song. I didn't really watch it. I'm not going to lie.
Okay, let's get.
She was performing a song, and then the person that she had as a feature, they started scissoring each other on stage, and people are mad about it.
That's awesome.
But I will say, it wasn't even a fucking full scissor, dude.
Was it like
they just slid into each other and then laid back
for like
and then
a dance for like a dance
Yeah.
Oh, why are people?
Have you
ever
seen Blades
out?
Of Glory?
Yeah.
You know that scene where they're like, they slide into each other?
Oh.
It was like that.
People are mad?
Yeah.
I mean, why? People are mad at them. Because people be mad about anything.
They're sexualizing. Ow.
There's a lot of kids.
They're sexualizing Katy Perry music, which is hypersexual.
They're like exploiting lesbianism and like using the lesbian thing for like entertainment when they're not actually
You're
lesbian.
You're telling me Katy Perry, who's like one of the LGBTQ like woo woo queens, is exploiting lesbianism?
I'm not the one complaining.
She's selling what she sells.
Lesbian sex. I mean, was it her first big song? I kissed a girl and I liked it.
Yes.
Yeah.
I kissed a girl and I liked it.
But the VMAs, there was a lot of making out at the VMAs this year.
Who made out?
I saw Sabrina Carpenter.
Sabrina Carpenter made out the alien.
Can I just?
Katy Perry made out with someone on stage or fake made out with them. And then she made out with Orlando Bloom.
Can I just fucking say?
Uh-huh.
I love Sabrina Carpenter a lot.
Yeah.
How in the fuck? I don't even think she was nominated, though. For Song of the Summer, how the fuck did Taylor Swift and Post Malone win?
They won video.
They won video of the summer?
I think so.
Thought they won Song of the Summer.
Was it Song of the Summer? Can you pull the list?
It's ruining my
Someone won
life.
Song of the Summer, and it wasn't Chapel or Sabrina Carpenter.
Chapel won Best New Artist.
Yeah, great.
I think is a better award.
I think that's a better award, but like... Song of the Summer should be for the song of the summer.
Taylor Swift won video.
She won video. Sabrina Carpenter.
Oh, yeah. No, she won Song of the Summer.
Oh, did she also win Song of the Summer?
You know what? I've never heard the song.
Somebody brought up a great fucking point.
Go on.
They're like, you're terminally online. I've never heard the song play ever.
I've never heard it.
I saw that on Twitter. I've never heard it.
I've never heard that song.
I've heard it because I listened to the album when it came out.
Mm-hmm.
I've never heard that song.
No, I haven't. It's the one with Post Malone specifically, though. Yeah. I don't think that's the one on the album.
You know what sucks? Apparently that song was supposed to be with Maddie Healy. And then they broke
I like
up.
Post better than Maddie, sorry.
I like Post.
It's such a 1975 vibe song, though.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Fuck, it would have been so good.
It is, but...
It would have been so good!
Chapel yelled at paparazzi, which I thought was hilarious, because I was like, bitch, I'm not even really talking to you.
Yes, so there's a video of her on the red carpet, and you hear somebody go, shut the fuck up! And she turns around, she's like, you shut the fuck up! Not me, bitch! Not me!
Yeah, I saw that.
But video. She wasn't even talking.
Yeah.
And I don't think the paparazzi was talking to her.
I think someone came out and was like, he wasn't talking to you.
Yeah.
Or like.
But, you know, the heat of the moment, whatever.
No, it was heat of the moment. It was a good clip for her.
Great clip
like,
for her.
She knows now, like, oh, being a strong, outspoken woman, like, I'm going to get, like, clicks for it, which is awesome.
Yeah. I mean, people have been talking about it. They're like, sorry, I'm asking my Discord for the sexy gif. I need to find it.
We're so moved on from that.
I'm not. I'm not, honey.
Focused up. I have a problem with Chapel. I want to focus on... Let's focus on Chapel.
Sure.
Chapel did a performance at the VMAs.
Yeah.
She was supposed to do a concert.
No, I think it was just one song.
She canceled her concerts in Paris.
No, she canceled concert. I think it was in Belgium.
Yeah. Many artists do that, especially if they have the opportunity to perform at the VMAs.
VMAs.
Yeah, I just think that's fucked because like people had to go and like they didn't get their money back.
I mean, they rescheduled.
They rescheduled it.
A concert I wanted to go to just got rescheduled.
Yeah, but you're getting refunded, right?
Everyone's getting refunded. No matter what, they're refunded.
I don't know.
They always refund.
I just feel anyone who's traveling to a concert.
There's no refunds. Yeah. I mean, there's no refunds for it because they're postponing the date.
Yeah.
But I think even Chapel's is rescheduled.
Yeah. I think it is too.
But I do get the point where like people are like traveling cross country.
Yeah. Yeah. Like,
and they
like,
waste money on hotels. But I would take it too. That's like a big career move for her. Like the millions and millions and millions
won.
Of eyes.
And she did. If she wasn't going to.
She did win.
That arguably is a bigger show than the Belgium show.
Well, yeah. I just think it's like. I don't know. I guess I'm being parasocial. I think I'm being parasocial.
Why
I'm calling myself out for parasocial.
Why? You, as a friend of Chapel?
I was literally about to say, like, the reason why she's there is because of the fans. It's kind of just, like, a giant middle finger to, like, the fans. And, like,
I don't know.
But, like, fuck them.
It's okay. It's okay.
It's
her first one.
She made the right call. I also would do the same exact thing.
Yeah.
Who am I to fucking be like, fuck you?
Exactly. Who are you? Who the fuck are you, Scoot?
I'm John Valjean. 24601.
Hell yeah, dude. Hell yeah. Chapel had a good performance as well.
She killed it.
But, you know, she needs more onstage practice.
Yeah.
She does. She was running out of breath. And I think it was just the costume and everything, too. But she's always worn big costumes. Also
the fact that there was a fire behind her.
Well, I think she was also nervous.
Yeah.
And there was just the breath control wasn't, like, the best. So, but it still was great.
My girl Sabrina killed it.
She's great.
I love watching
old Sabrina clips from like back on Disney Channel when she was like afraid of autism.
Dude, her calling.
So funny.
Her calling fucking, what's her name? An alien.
Who?
So good. When she did like her song about like, you'll taste me.
Oh, she was calling Camila Cabello?
She wasn't calling her an alien. It's just the theme of the VMAs. I think she was like tapping into the VMA.
I don't know.
Like astronaut.
I think it was subliminal.
It was definite. Dude, you can just make a person blue and she can still be hot. That was a full ass fucking like giant eyeballed alien.
Yeah.
There was definitely some shit there.
Yeah. You think that was shade?
Do not think she was throwing shade.
It wasn't shade at all.
If anything,
she would have brought back Jenna Ortega again.
I'm saying she could have done that.
And the music video was completely shade to her.
Jenna Ortega's still doing that press tour for.
Yeah.
I don't think the music video was shade to her at all.
I didn't watch it.
I mean, I know they're killing each other and it's like all horror
movie. And then they make out with each other. But like, yeah.
She's getting Jenna Ortega to play her. Like, that's not shade.
I mean,
she got a bug eyed ass alien to play her.
Yeah, I mean, because she did the VMAs team because the award is an astronaut.
Right. But all I'm saying is like, you could have just made a woman blue. They added a mask of prosthetics.
Yeah, they made an alien.
Yeah.
Britney hated it.
Spears?
Yeah. I don't understand why Sabrina would make out with an alien. She should have just made out with a woman.
What?
Yeah.
Was that what was said?
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. Britney. She's like, she should have just been like me, you know? But the VMAs are so like now, dude. I wish there was more crazy shit.
I want people calling Miley Cyrus a chicken breast bitch again. I want people getting mad at Robin Thicke.
They don't call her chicken breast. It is literally chicken ass of like the whole chicken.
Oh.
Yeah, because it looks like a raw chicken.
Oh.
It's fine.
Dude, I remember whenever Miley performed at the VMAs in like 2013 or 2014. Uh-oh.
And I don't know
why.
It's okay.
It's not okay.
Yeah, it's fine.
Because we don't have your face.
Pick it up on one of the other cameras.
Yeah.
We got super close to you that one time, so we have that at least.
Yeah.
Yeah.
When Scootish harassed me and touched my face.
Well, don't say that. We don't have HR here today.
Yeah, we don't.
Fired them.
Why are you high-fiving?
Because it's Scoot.
Would you like if he touched your face?
I've kissed him.
Yeah, we've kissed. No Diddy.
You want him to kiss? Do you want us to kiss again?
No.
He doesn't want it.
I don't want it. I'm sorry, okay, Scoot.
That's fair. I understand.
I've moved on from that phase of my life.
Okay. You're secure in your sexuality now?
I have to. I have to be. I'm very plenty secure in my sexuality. I don't need to prove it anymore.
Okay.
Yeah, just like damn. See, whenever, I can't make up my friends
whenever,
anymore.
Whenever I was talking about touching your face, I meant with like a finger.
Huh?
I meant with a finger.
Yeah, Scoot can touch my face as long as he doesn't eat before he does it. But that's for anyone. As long as they don't eat, they can touch my face. I don't care. As long as I know where Scoot's hands have been, and he's been here, so we're good. Yeah.
I don't like being touched. No, not with feet. That's where crazy. I draw the line.
That's crazy. Did you just fart, dude?
Ah, fire, dude. That's fire, you sicko.
Good edge.
You fucking sick fuck.
Where are we at time-wise?
Oh, we're way past an hour.
Okay, cool. I still want to finish this conversation. I was just checking in. What, like, I want it to be more crazy, the VMAs. Like, there's
what do you
not
want? What's your ideal VMAs?
I want someone to, like... Remember the VMAs that one year where Sacha Baron Cohen came flying down and like was like butt naked basically in front of Eminem's face?
Yes.
Don't Don't look at me like that. Ooh, it turned off.
It did not like that you said that. the camera did not like that you said that.
No, I didn't like your reaction to me calling. Yeah. I know he's a Zionist, but...
But I want crazy shit like that. They don't do that anymore. Although Megan Thee Stallion was great.
It wasn't crazy, though.
It wasn't crazy. The performances were all good. Teddy Swims. Oh, man. Who? Teddy Swims. Teddy Swims. You do know who he is. You've heard his songs before. I lose in control.
Oh, yeah, I do.
When you're not next to me. Because he was in the back room or whatever doing like the in-between concerts. So good.
Can I give a fucked up take, but I think it's a
good one.
It's a good one.
Let's hear it.
Pop music died in like 2010.
Yeah.
Nothing compares to like the Lady Gaga, Rihanna, Katy Perry. Mm-hmm. Who else is like a big pop girly like 2008 to 2000?
Like, I want to see, like, show me Bush, dude. Like, show me, like, I want, like, if Orlando Bloom came out and was like, yeah, my wife, I love her, she's great, here's my bush, and, like, just showed his fucking bush, like, do some crazy shit.
I want, like, the equivalent of Janet Jackson Nipplegate.
Yeah, dude, Nipplegate was solid. Or, like, the making out of, like, random people just making out on stage was like, okay, like, we've seen that already.
Yeah.
So, it's like, I don't know.
You kissed, big fucking deal.
Like, bring out, like, a little person or something. Like, just something different.
Dude, you know what was a shocking thing for me when I went to Creator Clash 2?
Uh-huh.
Somebody brought a possum.
What? Yeah, do that. Bring a possum.
Somebody brought a possum and that's I pet insane. It. And then I was like, I think I have a disease now.
Yeah, dude, that's crazy.
But it was so cute. I never saw one in person.
People's fucking, like, people's like, choice and, like, what is it? Like, what is that called? Animal? The security animal? Come on, someone please help me out.
Security animal, like emotional
support. Thank you, emotional support animal.
No, it wasn't even emotional support. It was a part of their entrance.
Oh. Okay.
Like, they walked in with, like, a whole posse, and a possum was a part of it.
Well, a posse of possums.
I wish, dude, but I pet it, and then I was like, I kind of had regret, but you know possums only live 2 years?
I didn't know that.
Yeah.
Isn't that sad?
I hate you. Just leave I it fucking
off.
Hate you.
Let's just leave it off. I think we're going to wrap.
Yeah, isn't that so sad?
It is sad that they only live for 2 years. I mean, lucky.
You know what's even sadder than
what?
That this is the end of the A-Raps podcast for the week. Catch us on the Patreon.
Yeah, guys.
And it's like, and we have Capri with us right here.
And then also,
we were done though, I think. I think we were done with that conversation. I mean, did you have anything else to say about the VMAs? I think I've said my whole thing. I think it was fine this year. I think the performances were good, but I wish it was crazier. Sorry, what were you thinking about? What were you in their mind palace for?
Think about you.
Okay, what about what though?
You. What more did you want to add to the conversation?
Nothing.
Did you
see you on the pot? See you on the Patreon.
See you guys on the Patreon. Yeah, go ahead.
We'll be live at
Live at TwitchCon 11:45. Give Please Theater. That's a Saturday.
Yeah,
on Saturday
11:45 a.m.
And give so yeah. I'm not going to do the comment below thing. Should we do it because he's not here?
Comment down below and say, Wallahi, we miss Capri.
Yeah.
Sad emoji.
See, yeah. Put down we miss Capri at the end of the...
He'll see that and he'll actually be happy about
guys,
it.
Guys, they really missed me. They really missed me. And he's not going to watch this fucking episode. We know he's not going to.
And then
going
he's going to be like, yeah, watch it and said it was a bad episode.
Yeah. Capri will do this thing. He'll watch it and then he'll be like, that was a bad episode. I should have been there.
I don't think...
And I'm going to be like, dude...
I won't lie to you. It won't perform well.
Hey.
It won't.
I don't care.
Hey. Neither do I. You know why?
Why?
I had fun.
Yeah, I had a
fun
good time.
With you guys. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, I had a good time with you, Scoot.
Thanks, guys.
So, thank you guys so much. Actually, my camera died, so one of you guys close it out.
Okay, bye. Out.
What if I don't want to?
Bye.
Krogan, what is your deal, Goodbye. Dude? We'll see you on the Patreon.
Bye-bye. I hope you find the man to tie you up.
But I also hope you never get tied down. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Hey. Amen, player.
Amen.
I never get high five for anything.
You don't offer it.